So y'all know this video got demonetized before it even went live. So go ahead and hit that thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment box and sound off and let me know y'all loving this look. Let's roll the intro. Curvy fashion for dolls and my fashion for dudes. How y'all doing? Welcome to another Coco's Couture Closet, home for all the trendy tips for plus size hips. I am Coco, and
this is my closet. 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 This is my closet.
If you are new here, hello, love. I am so happy you decided to stop by. Please stick around, like, comment, and subscribe, and become one of Coco's curvy fashion for dolls or dudes. And if you are already a subscriber, mwah, it's great to be back here with you in the couture closet. Now, whether you are a new subby or an old subby, hit that bell below, guys. Pound it so that when I upload a new video,
you can be the first to know, so you can be the first to watch. Yes, honey, yes.
And make sure you all follow me on all of my social media platforms. I am Dr. Coco underscore curves on both Instagram and TikTok, and Miss Perfect 1988 on Snapchat. Snapchat is where all the exclusives drop before they make it over here to the channel. All right, cutie, so I'm back with our first haul for September, and this is gonna be the bedroom boom edition, plus size fashion haul featuring lingerie from two different places, and I think that I have a piece from Shein that I might throw in the end. I'm not sure yet, but I picked up some lingerie from Savage X Fenty, as well as some lingerie from Love Vera, and I want to show you guys all of it. But before we get into this video, I want to give a special shout out to Dossier. Yes, you guys, Dossier sent over two more fragrances for us to smell and let them know our feedback on. And also for you guys, they sent over a link with a coupon code attached to it so that you all can get some coin off of your Dossier purchase. So like always, when we're working with Dossier, I'm going to insert a brief clip, and then we're going to come back and smell some fragrances that are going to be perfect to match your sexy sleigh when you purchase from this
cuties. So as we officially welcome Dossier into the Couture Closet family, I wanted to take a minute to give you all a up close and personal of what your Dossier package will look like when it arrives, each fragrance individually boxed and ready to wear. And also give you some brief information about Dossier, tell you a little bit about the company so you know exactly who you're shopping with. Dossier believes that fragrances should be made for everyone, not just a lucky few. Not only do they make fragrances affordable by removing the designer brand and retailer markups, celebrity endorsements, fees, and etc., they also produce vegan, cruelty-free products with 100% clean ingredients, as well as focus on sustainability. At $29 each only, you can't resist trying them out, at least knowing that you've made a smart choice for your skin, your health, and your environment. Dossier takes away retail markup and commission, packaging overhead. And don't believe me? Try Dossier out for yourself by using their risk-free perfume purchase program. Want to know more about it? Stay tuned in the video. I'll give you all the deets.
Okay, so let's do a smell test of the fragrances that we received from Dossier. Now, this first fragrance is... this is Musky Oak Moss. Musky Oak Moss has top notes of apple, pineapple, and bergamot, middle notes of rose, birch leaf, and patchouli, and base notes of musk, oak moss, and amber. It's inspired by Creed Avengers, and this is actually a men's scent. So I want to smell this and see if hubby is going to like the way it smells. And also, I'm not a fan. I'm not opposed to wearing men's fragrances if I feel like they give more of a unisex vibe. I don't really like them harsh, but I do like them. I like my perfume strong and like for them to speak before I enter the room. So if I find a men's fragrance that does that, I'll definitely be into it. Ooh. Oh, this smells sexy, y'all. Ooh, I can't wait to spray some of this on hubby. It smells good. You can't really smell the apple or the pineapple, but you can definitely smell the birch leaf and the patchouli. You can smell the rose and oak moss and amber as well. So the actual apple and pineapple that I would normally smell from my sense, because I like mine's fruity, they aren't very potent in here. Just a dash of them, so that this is definitely a masculine scent to me. So this is definitely for hubby. I can't wait for him to spray it on. So this next fragrance is Oriental Cherry. It has top notes of cherry, almond, and cinnamon. Middle notes of cloves, rose, jasmine, and plum. And base notes of Peru Basilum, Tonka bean, and vanilla. Those are new notes for me. This is inspired by Tom Ford's Lost Cherry. Now, I liked Tom Ford the last time we tried it, and so that's what made me pick another Tom Ford product again. Ooh, okay, she smells good. Ooh, I like. So definitely I smell the cherry, the almond, and the cinnamon. Now, I didn't see cinnamon on the car. Oh, yes, I did. I definitely smell those top notes, and I smell the vanilla. Ooh, that's nice. I'm going to give myself a little squirt of that. I don't have no perfume on. I usually will spray myself with some perfume just to, you know, get me in the mood for recording. I smell delicious, y'all. I love it. So make sure you all shop Dossier. There will be links. Use my link in the description box, you guys. Help your girl out. Show Dossier. I don't get paid for the link, you guys. The link is strictly for you all. The coupon code is strictly for you all. But what it does show when you click the link is that you all are watching my videos. And the things that I refer, you all are actually interested in, which means the Dossier will continue to want to work with the girl. And that's what we want, right? We want long-term partnerships and relationships over here, right? Exactly. So thank you to Dossier for sending over these amazing smelling perfume and cologne. And let's roll the video. Let's get into this first look I have on, because she is sexy. Now, she has some cons, but she definitely has more pros than cons. So I want to talk about those pros first. I love the pattern on here. I love the way that they blended the blue and the purple together. I love the rose detail. Also, the lace along the top of the bra and the complete lace that is the underwear. I love this look. I also like the leggings too. I feel like they're a good blend, and this makes for a gorgeous, gorgeous set. Now, the bra fits amazing. I'm wearing a 44 triple D, and it fits perfect. It has some light padding in it and amazing boning in it, exactly how I like my bras. I actually like a little more padding, but because the boning is so strong, it's perfect for me. It has a rose gold little circle here, where normally there would be a Savage Fenty, the X for Savage. It would usually be hanging from here. Maybe it was and I broke it. I don't remember, because I have worn this for hubby already. But I love this. The straps on the bra are thick. That's one thing I feel like with all of my bras from Savage that have straps, I can count on those straps to be secure. In the back, you have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 prongs that hold the bra together, and you can put it in on three different levels. The back of the bra, which you'll see in a second, also has a thick band for extra support, extra roll coverage, whatever you want to use it for. These boy shorts are so pretty. They are all lace, and then they have the Savage Fenty name across the band. So freaking cute. And I love the garter belts that are included on these. These are perfect, but you're gonna need them if you get these tights. Now, as you can see, these tights probably have been rolling for as long as I have been standing here. Do not buy these tights if you're not gonna wear some form of a garter with them. Now, it doesn't have to be this garter in particular, but this is definitely gonna need some support, because these roll. And even with the garters, they still roll. I actually think that I'm not gonna purchase any more hot thigh highs from Savage, because they're just not meeting my expectations. The stocking types, they rip. And then these that are not the stocking types, they don't have the adhesive in them. And so they roll. So either they're ripping, but they come all the way up, or they come all the way up and then they roll. So I'm just going to stick to buying the full-blown tights and the full-blown stockings from them. When we come to the side, we see the silhouette is looking cute. She's nice and cheeky, y'all. I told y'all they're going to be demonetizing my video for this. So support your girl and sound off in the comments, because this is cheeky. When you turn around, it's completely see-through because it's all lace. And so, and it's bottom cheeky. So the bottom butt cheeks are out on this. And now you can get a good visible look at what I'm saying about the back band. When we come to this side, again, we have a cheeky silhouette situation going on. And then we're back to the front and she's a sexy slay. So let me know what you all think about this first look. I'm absolutely in love with it. Husband was absolutely in love with it. Even though the tights stressed me out a bit, I still love the look. Y'all know I'm in love. Y'all know that I'm in love with a chocolate nude set. And this two-piece all-lace chocolate nude set is from Love Vera. Now, I want to say that Love Vera is a Black-owned brand, but I am not 100% sure of that. I do know that I feel like they use the hashtag Black-owned business, and that's how I originally found them, but do not quote me on that. If you know if they're Black owned, please comment down below and let everybody else know. But in the meantime, this gorgeous two-piece set, I am absolutely in love with it. You have cheeky high-waist all-lace boy shorts. Then you have an all-lace bralette to match. Now, y'all know I'm not the biggest fan of the bralette, and this is no exception. I am not the biggest fan of this bralette. As a set, absolutely gorgeous. But as separates, the bralette could have used some work. I want for bralettes to start having boning, to start having wires. And I know that that's a lot to say because bralettes typically are meant to be a bra, but not a full, you know, security blanket like a bra is. But I just don't, you know. So the good thing about Love Vera is that you get to pick the size of each piece that you get. You don't, just because it's a set, you don't have to pick all the same size. And you get the set for one price. All of these nude sets, because there are several shades of this, it looks like every skin tone of black is what they went for. And that those are the type of things that make me think that it's an all black owned company, because of the different skin tones and how they try to promote, you know, the fact that they're inclusive in their skin tone color. Now, the shorts fit great. In hindsight, I could have got a 4XL in the shorts, but I don't think it would have made much of a difference. I feel like as much coverage as this is going to provide, the 3X is doing a good job at that. I love the logo piece right here. That is so cute. And the logo piece here. I'm trying hard to stand a certain way so the logo won't buckle, even though you can see it starting to buckle. And that's one of the cons that you get when you're dealing with a bralette. The bralette does have adjustable straps on it, so that's perfect as well. When you turn to the side, the thigh and a piece of the butt cheek is exposed, which is preparing you for me to turn around. But the sides do provide great coverage of the fupa and of like side fupa, side stomach, side rolls and everything. This lace panty portion does a good job. Now, it's meant to be high cut. It's meant to be thong style. So that's why in the rear, this is coming right up into the butt. The top and the bottom both have the logo Love Vera around it. Now, this is completely see-through. There is no lining. There is none of that under here. It's completely see-through. It's meant to be lingerie, and I love it. I actually am going to look and see if some of their other pieces come in nudes in my shade of nude, because I have to have them. I told y'all this video was going to be cheeky, and honey, this bodysuit from Savage X Fenty, she cheeky, she fupa exposed, honey. She is out here. But honey, you know what? I'm here for it. And I wouldn't wear no damn robe either, because they already demonetized my shit 3 looks back. Anyway, this next look is from Savage X Fenty. It's a one-piece all-mesh bodysuit lined in this beautiful red-orange color. Y'all remember that color red-orange from the crayon box? That's what this is giving me. The straps are red-orange, the lining and the flowers, and of course, it has the signature rose gold hardware all over it. Even the clamps in the crotch have the rose gold hardware, as well as the garters here. They also have the rose gold hardware. Now, with this having garters, I can only assume that it actually comes with stockings or leggings of some sort, because there are garters in the rear as well. But when I bought this, I did not see them, because these pieces from Savage Fenty are actually from like last month and the month before last. I bought these during my vacation time. I love this though. I love it. Now, I would even wear this with some jeans. Like, I would wear some light blue jeans with this and maybe some pasties to cover up, you know, a little better of my nipples. But, you know, I like it. I think it's really cute, and husband loved it too. On the side, she's hot. She's high. You all can see a piece of my fupa. Y'all know that if y'all been rocking with me long enough, y'all know that this is something I'm trying to get used to. I bought all those swimming suits with all the fupa out, and I'm trying to adjust to that new style that's like suns out, all of the buns out, front and back buns. And so yeah, I'm adjusting, but honey, I still get a little cringy about it, but still, I think I look beautiful, and yeah, the whole side is out, and so is the rear. On the other side, we have the fupa out, like I said, but it's really high cut, but it's still such a pretty look on the melanin skin. I absolutely love it. This next two-piece set is also from La Vera, and it is another bralette. Y'all, I know I said I did not want to purchase a bunch of bralettes, but this was on sale. It's purple, and I thought it was so freaking cute. This is a all-lace two-piece set. Now, unlike the signature lines, when it comes to the sale items and things that are maybe limited edition, limited time only, you can't choose what size you want in the top and the bottom. So I got a size 3X, 4X, and the 3X, 4X fits amazing. In the bottom, you have all lace underwear, and then there is this satin line that makes up the waistband. Very, very pretty. But I wish I was able to get a 3X actually in this one. Now, when I turn around, you'll see that this is a T-strap razor back. And so that's the difference between the way that my chest sit in this one and me feeling like I need a 3X, and the way that my chest sits in the other one and me feeling like I need a 4X. Now, this is completely laced, but outside of it being completely laced, everything in the front is pretty much covered. The fupa is covered in full. When you turn to the side, there's no hanging fupa out or anything like that. But of course, when you turn to the rear, this is a thong style boy short, so it is high cut. Now you all can see the T-strap design that I was telling you about, the way the razor back look that the bra is made of. The bralette itself, though, is very long in length. It does come quite a bit over, you know, the chest area. It's a, you can tell it was extended on purpose because it's plus size, and I like that. I feel like that was a listening to your audience and reading the room, because one of the things that I complained about with the last bralette is that I felt like it was too short and it was rolling under. I wish that that brown bralette may have had a little more material under the signature name logo like this one does here. But I still like it, and I did catch it on sale. I think it was like $30. And last time I checked, it was still available online. This is the final look, you guys, from Savage X Fenty. She is another one of my faves. You all, if you all follow me on the gram, then you all know that me and my husband took a very sexy picture while we were on our anniversary trip to Cancun. And I actually had this on. I am in love with this set. It is a gorgeous two-piece high-cut thong and matching, I don't want to call this a bralette, but it is a strapless bra. And it also, I can't think of what I want to call it, bustier. a bra bustier. So that's what we'll call it. We have a matching thong and bra bustier set that I absolutely love. It's lime green, but it has like this zebra print aesthetic into it. The lines are horizontal. You know, I feel like horizontal lines widen the physique and widen the body and everything. But because these are actually sitting on the hips, I don't mind having my hips look a little wider. You know how I feel about my hips. I wish they was a little fuller. But anyway, I love this set. The panties are high cut, but they are also high waist and full in coverage. So my whole fupa, whether I'm from the front or the side, is covered up. Now, as much as I like this top and as much as I like the aesthetic of the strapless look and then the V-neck, these kind of even look like little cat ears. My problem is this. This has boning in it, but I still felt the need to wear a strapless bra. Yes, even in my pictures in Cancun, I did have on a strapless bra. This one, actually, this is my Savage Fenty strapless, and it did come in handy under here. Now, you have wiring, boning here in the front. You have boning here on the side. They should have put boning underneath because without my strapless bra, my breasts just do not look attractive to me in this. This starts to buckle and bend like so. It's just not a supportive bra at all without the aid of another bra underneath. And So if you want it for a sex appeal in this look, go for it. If you're looking for support, stay away from it. What I like also is that the band is a wide band. So my strapless bra's wide band is wider, so you can see it a little bit. But this corset bra actually has a nice wide width band in itself, and it has boning on the side, but it's some flimsy boning, y'all. I'm not gonna lie. When we turn to the back, this is a thong, so it is high cut. I love it, though. I love the neon green, how it pops, how it's sitting on the melanin skin. Absolutely gorgeous. Definitely a fave. I have to be honest, they all are faves of mine. The Love Vera and the Savage Fenty. The Love Vera more so for the looks, and the Savage Fenty more so for the style. But I love them both. That's the entire haul, you guys. That is my entire haul. My first haul of September and my first lingerie haul in quite a minute. I hope that you all enjoyed it. I hope you all found some great ideas for shopping for your own lingerie, got some good tips along the way, and learned about some new perfume scents that you all must try. Thank you so much to Dossier for sending over those fragrances. Looking forward to working with you all in the future. And thank you all to my subbies. I love y'all so, so much. Thank y'all for y'all feedback from my last video and my last post about the vlogs. I got a big surprise coming up for y'all, so stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, continue to like, comment, and subscribe, because we still going for 2K all the way. I love you all, and until next time, like I always say, bring your mama, bring your sister, bring your auntie, bring your cousin, bring your gay uncle, baby. Hell, bring your baby, because we got room, and there is always room for curves in Coco's Couture Closet. I'll catch you guys later. Bye, guys.